Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our lesson that is Fundamental Unit of Life. In my previous session, I have explained you about cell membrane. Today also, we are going to talk about cell membrane itself. Little bit in detail, we are going to talk about cell membrane. Okay? At the end of that session, I have talked to you about fluid mosaic model. Means the cell membrane is actually composed of what? Okay, see, suppose here if it is a cell membrane, I say you, if it is a cell membrane, if we will have a closer look or if you will try to see under the microscope, high definition microscope, if you will try to see, then we will get to see the structure like this, students. Of the cell membrane. What happens here? You can see here this structure. Actually, I said you, cell membrane is composed of lipoprotein. Lipoprotein word is divided into two, lipids and proteins. So, what is lipid over here and what is protein over here? You can see this structure. This structure is called as a protein. These nutrients or whatever the material it is there, how it is passes, that we are going to learn in detail in this class. Okay, so why it is called as a selectively permeable membrane? So first of all, we will see it will allow the entry of the particular material. Particular material means what, students? See, there are metabolic activities are taking place, right? Metabolic processes are taking place, such as respiration, digestion. There are various metabolic processes are taking place in our body, and these metabolic processes require what? Oxygen. Okay, for the respiration process, for breaking down of glucose, or breaking down of carbohydrates to convert into glucose, we need oxygen. So oxygen is needed for the cell. right? Oxygen is needed for the cell. So it will allow the entry for what? Oxygen. Okay, it allow entry for metabolic product such as oxygen, right? Oxygen is needed for the cell to prepare the food, okay? To convert it into the energy. Oxygen is needed. What else is needed, students? Salts are needed, right? Water is needed. Without water, the cell cannot survive for long, right? Because cytoplasm is present inside it and some important cell organelles are also present. So, cell cannot survive without water. So, oxygen, salt, water, some protective nutrients means what? Like our minerals as well as our vitamins, and very important, students, which we are in need, that is food. Means what? Nutrients. Food means nutrients. Selectively permeable membrane. It allows the entry of only selected material. Selected material means what? The material which is needed for the cell for the survival, right? So cell needed food, cell needed nutrients, right? Cell needed the protective nutrients like minerals and vitamins. Cell needed oxygen. Cell needed some salts, right? So this all the things. And water, obvious water is needed. So this all material is needed for the cell, right? So it allows the entry of this particular material. And it allow to exit of what exactly? See, it permit to exit. What might be there? As I said you, metabolic products are needed. At the same time, metabolic waste is also created. Metabolic waste means what? Metabolic waste such as CO2, carbon dioxide. We get rid of carbon dioxide. And what? Nitrogenous waste. Okay? Nitrogenous waste such as urea and uric acid. Okay? So, it allows the entry of metabolic waste. As well as it allow the exit also of the metabolic waste such as carbon dioxide and some nitrogenous waste. Okay, students, it is going out. This is coming inside the cell membrane. This is going out of the cell membrane. And there are some products which are living into the cell forever or for long. For what, student? As we are knowing, we need energy for every now and then. For our metabolic processes, respiration, digestion, nutrition, blood circulation, reproduction events, for all these life processes we need energy. And that energy we are getting from the, as you have learned in class 8, we are getting that energy from the mitochondria. Okay? And energy is stored in the form of ATP into the mitochondria. So some metabolic byproduct are stored, some metabolic byproducts, students. This is the third point. This is first point, this is second point, and this is third point. Some metabolic byproduct, what? Such as ATP stored into the what? Mitochondria, okay? This metabolic product is stored into the mitochondria in the form of ATP. That is the energy currency of the body, because we need energy for our physical activity. We need energy. But whenever we are not doing anything, we are simply sitting. That time also, from inside our this machinery, means our body is working. And for that sake also we need energy. And that energy we are getting from the ATP. So if the question would come into the exam, why cell membrane is called as a selectively permeable membrane, then you must write all these 3 points. These are needed. You may take screenshot or you may write the notes, no problem. Okay, so I hope you understand about the cell membrane. Okay, now students, we will see how these particles are coming inside and how some particles are going outside. Okay, so here we are going to talk about the transportation of the material. Okay, so here we will see now transportation. Transportation of this food material, of this water, of this salt, then oxygen, then going some material out of the body, oxygen, okay, then nitrogenous waste, as I said you. So how does this transportation occurs into the cell membrane? Especially student, there are 3 ways, okay, there are 3 ways for the transportation. What are those ways? First way is what? Active transportation. Active transportation. Second way is passive transportation. Passive transportation. And third is bulk transportation. See, students, it may be not included in your textbook, but whenever you will read textbook, that time if you will see this video lecture carefully, you will be able to understand every line of your textbook. So that it is needed. Okay, I am going to talk about this active, passive and bulk transportation in detail. See students, suppose if you will talk about the cell membrane, okay, this is the cell membrane, and at the inside the cell, okay, this is the actually cell has 2 parts, no? Intrinsic means outside, the part is there which is out of the cell, and inside the cell. So if we will talk about this inside the cell, inside, and this part is outside of the cell, okay, and here are some particles, okay, salt particles, we may say iron particles, okay, and here are also some particles. Okay, now you will see the difference in between the particles. If you will see inside of the cell, this is cell membrane, okay, just to understand you, this is cell membrane. Inside the particles are more, outside the particles are less. If I will talk about passive transportation, means if it is decided to move the particles from higher concentration to the lower concentration by the cell membrane, it will be very easy. It will be really very easy. It will be just like a slide. Okay, whenever we are going into the park, okay, we like that game to move from the slide, means from top to the bottom when we move down. Or if there is a bike which is moving from the slope, the bike or by those who are riding that bike, if they are moving from the high to the low ground of the that road, then it is very easier. It does not require any energy. Do you understand, students? It does not require any energy. Why? We can give our other example also. When we get down from the stair, whenever we are getting down, we need very less energy. Na ke barabar. We need very less energy. So from whenever we are getting down, the students, from the stair, we need very less energy. So here also, when the particles are moving from high concentration to the low concentration, it requires no energy, or we can say there is no requirement of the energy. Particles can move anyhow from the higher concentration to the low concentration because it does not require any energy. Okay, we can take example of slide just now I gave you. It does not need any energy. Okay, but when the particles are moving from low concentration to the high concentration, we need a lot amount of energy. Okay, and that energy, if you are talking about cell, if you are talking about cell, there are some ions, students, outside of the cell and inside of the cell. And these ions are coming inside the cell, while some ions are going outside of the cell by the process of active transportation. And for the moment, such as ions, I would like to take the names also, sodium and potassium ion especially. That is called as the sodium potassium ion pump. That process you will learn in higher classes in detail. So what happens is potassium and sodium ion, when they are exchanging from outside to inside and from inside to outside, they need a lot amount of energy, right? And that energy is taken from where? We have energy in our body, into the cell, into the mitochondria, right? We have energy in the form of ATP. So that energy is utilized from the ATP, okay? But here we need some energy because the particle has to move from the lower concentration to the higher concentration. I hope you understand, okay? In plants, such kind of passive transportation is taking place for what? Some amount of salts. At the same time, I said you just now, for some amount of salt to exchange, we need it. Okay, and in animal cell, we need such type of transportation, active transportation. Whenever we are doing any physical activity, we need that muscle more energy. So that energy is taking from the cell of the ATP, okay, from the ATP of the cell. So amino acids as well as glucose is taking into the cell by the process of the active transportation. I hope you understand, okay? In plants, some salts and some ions are taken in and outside by the process of active transportation by using ATP energy, and in animals, the proteins or amino acids and glucose is taken by the active transportation. Means energy is needed, and that energy is taken from the ATP, okay, from the cell, which is present into the mitochondria, okay? This frequently I am repeating because it is very important, students, to learn the higher chapters and next chapters of the further classes. You should know this, okay? So this is what? Passive transportation. Active transportation, okay? If you will talk about the passive transportation is bifurcated into two things. Passive transportation is bifurcated into two things. First of all, passive transportation means what? If it is the cell membrane again, if this is inside, and if suppose this is outside. Okay, this is outside and inside. And here are the more particles and here are the less particles. Okay, here are the more particles I have to show you. Now, this particle will move from high concentration to the low concentration. This particle will move from high concentration to the low concentration. Okay, as they will move from the high concentration to low concentration, okay, means again I would like to give example of what? Slide. From the slide, from the top to the bottom, when we are coming, we don't need any energy. So such kind of transportation is called as a passive transportation. It does not require any energy. It does not require any energy. Does not require any energy. Okay? This is passive process because particles are moving from high concentration to the low concentration. Okay? And its flow is bidirectional. Its flow is bidirectional. Bidirectional means the particles can move from low concentration to the high concentration to become equal, as from high concentration to the low concentration. Thus, the flow of this particle will be bidirectional. As well as it is physical process. It is physical process. Okay? And if we will go backward little bit about our active transportation, then it requires energy. If the difference would ask by me, what is the difference between the active transportation and the passive transportation, then you should write, active transportation need a lot amount of energy. Second point will be, it flows only in one direction, okay? And third point is, it is biochemical process. Active transportation is biochemical process, right? but it is physical process. Its flow is bidirectional and it does not require any energy. The particles are always moving from high concentration to the low concentration. Okay, whenever we are getting down from the stair, that is from high concentration to the low concentration. Okay, it does not require any energy. Now this is passive transportation is bifurcated into two points. What are those? You might have learned also previously. There are two processes, students. Diffusion and osmosis. Diffusion and osmosis. Okay, what is mean by diffusion? The movement of the particle. See, the movement of the particle from particle. Now here particle means what? It may be solid, it may be liquid, or it may be gaseous. The movement of the particle from of solid, liquid and gases from high concentration to low concentration across the cell membrane is called as a diffusion. Okay, I hope you understand this process. Diffusion means what? The movement of the particles. The particles may be solid, may be liquid, may be gaseous, from high concentration to the low concentration through cell membrane, which is called as what? Selectively permeable membrane. Okay, but here the difference would be in the diffusion. In the gaseous particle, the movement of the particle from high concentration to the low concentration will be faster. Okay, into the liquid it will be little slower, and in the solid it will be very slow. Okay, so this is the difference into the diffusion of the gaseous into the liquid and into the solid. Okay, so this is all about diffusion. Now we will move ahead for the osmosis process. Okay, here we are going to have a long talk on a osmosis. Okay, what is mean by osmosis? Osmosis is what? Osmosis is what? The movement of water. The movement of water. Okay, from high concentration to low concentration through selectively permeable membrane, that is cell membrane, across the cell membrane. Okay, across cell membrane is called what? Is called as osmosis. Okay, in diffusion we have seen solid, liquid and gas all can move from high concentration to the low concentration. Osmosis means what? The particle of water only are moving from high concentration to the low concentration. Okay, if this movement of water from high concentration to the low concentration is depend on what? Is depend on the concentration of water. See students, have you ever the concept of concentrated and diluted? What is meant by concentrated and diluted? See, your mother is making, this is the season of our lemonade. Okay, we drink, we like to drink it, but while preparing it, what we do? We are adding into the lemon juice, we add some amount of water and then we drink it. But when we take out only lemon juice, then is it possible us to drink? No, it's not possible for us to drink, because it is not concentrated. Okay, the amount of the solute particle, if it is more into the solution, then that is called as a concentrated solution. Okay, if the amount of the solute particle is less into the solution, then it is called as a diluted solution. Okay, so the movement of the water particle is depend on the concentration of the water. Understood? See, suppose this is the beaker, okay? And this beaker contains water, 100 ml water. And if I will add 60 gram of salt in it, 60 gram of salt in it, then what will happen? This solution will be too salty, right? This solution will be too much salty. Means salt will be what? Salt will be solute, water will be solvent, and all together it's what? Solution. And this solution is concentrated solution. Okay, students, if we will take another beaker, I add water in it, and if I will add only 10 gram of salt in it, then such solution will be diluted solution. I hope this concept is clear for you. Concentrated solution means what? The amount of solute particle, means amount of salt, will be more, then that is called as a concentrated solution. And if the amount of salt particle will be less, then that solution is called as a diluted solution. I hope this concept is clear. Now we will go ahead, because with the help of this concept only we have to understand the further concepts. Okay, so the movement of the water particle, it depends on the concentration of the water, right? So there are two types of movement of the water. What are those? Endoosmosis and exoosmosis. Endo means what happens? If this is the cell, then from surrounding the water will enter inside. The movement of water will be from outside to inside, right? Because inside the cell there is a less amount of water, and we have seen into the passive transport, the water or the gases are moving from high concentration to the low concentration. So outside the cell membrane the amount of water is more, inside it the amount of water is less. So the movement of the water from outside to inside until what? The concentration becomes, sorry, the water particles become equal. Okay, means the major event here, it would be from outside the water will be coming inside, from high concentration to the low concentration, and this process is called as what? Endosmosis. The movement of water particle from high concentration to the low concentration, means from outside of the cell to inside of the cell, is called as endoosmosis. And I hope the further concept might be clear for you. What is exoosmosis? It will be exactly opposite of it. It will be exactly opposite of it. Means the water particles will move from high concentration to the low concentration, means inside the component of water are more, while outside the component of water are less. So what will happen? The water will move from high concentration to the low concentration, means water will move from cell to outside of the cell. Okay, across the cell membrane, the water, the particles of the movement of the water from outside, from inside to outside, and that is called what? Exoosmosis. I hope you understand this. Is it clear for you, students? Endoosmosis and exoosmosis. It's what? The movement of the water particle from high concentration to the low concentration. The concentration outside, if it is more of water, then water will enter inside, and the process is called as endoosmosis. If inside the water component are more than outside, then water will move from out, inside to outside, and that is called as a exoosmosis. Okay, but this exoosmosis and endoosmosis is depend on the concentration of water. It depend on the concentration of water. For that sake, I have to explain you there are three types of solutions: hypotonic solution, then hypertonic solution, and next one, isotonic solution. Isotonic solution. Hypotonic. Here what would happen? Here this I would like to give a hypotonic solution with the example, with a simple example. See you students, your mother is preparing bhaji of green gram, right? Green gram, chana, moong, right? So directly she don't prepare it. She keeping it for soaking whole night. She is putting it, means she keep it for soaking for whole night. Overnight she is keeping into the utensil, okay, by adding water. But whenever she put them into the water, inside it there is a less concentration of water, right? But on the next day, when she is trying to make, when she is about to make the bhaji, at that time what happens? Those beans are turgid. Those beans or mutter or whatever it is turgid. Means it contains a water in it. Where does this water have come from? Because when we have kept it for the soaking, that time what happens? Outside the concentration of water was more, inside the concentration of water is less. So water has taken from outside to inside by the process of endosmosis. And why it has happened? Because hypotonic solution. Hypotonic solution means what? Outside only water was there. Amount of water is more into that utensil than into the cell, than into the plant cell, right? So the movement of water has taken from outside to the inside. That because that solution is what? Hypotonic. Hypo means what? Less. Less amount of salt were dissolved in it, right? Or less amount of salt was there. Complete water was there. Diluted water was there. And so that this process was possible, right? The movement was possible from outside to inside because that water was what? Hypotonic. And the direction of that water molecule will be from high concentration to the low concentration. Means the movement from high concentration to the low concentration. Now, if we will talk about hypertonic, right? Again, same gram, same moon, we will take there and we will try to put them into the salty water. Now what we will do? We'll take one utensil, we'll add salt in it, salt, and we will put all those swollen green gram or chana or whatever it will be into the salty water. Now student, what will happen? As this chana or green gram contains a lot of water inside it, they become turgid. Turgid means what? The amount of water into the cell is more. That is called as a turgidity. That process we will learn later. So this cells of, we can say the cells or this particles or this chana has become turgid, okay, because of the presence of water. But if you have a loop over it, then outside it the salt is more. Means the solution is what? Concentrated. Solution is concentrated. In this case, what will happen, student? The particles will move from outside, from inside to outside. Right? From inside to outside, the particle of the water will move by the process of exosmosis due to the hypertonic solution. Hypertonic solution. Hyper means excess. Hypertension, hyperacidity, we are using this word. Hypertonic means what? Hyper means excess. Excess amount of salt is dissolved into the water, so that solution becomes concentrated. So inside the cell there is a more amount of water, and for that sake what will happen? That water would come out of the cell to become a stable, okay, means inside and outside the concentration of the water will be same. Because of this, what happened? As in previous we have seen that cell particles or cell become turgid, but here in this case what will happen? The cell will shrink, right? The cell will shrink, or that is called as a shrunken cell, okay? That is called as a shrunken cell. Shrunken, toxin. And in first case, what will happen? Or flaccid also it can be said. It called the shrunken cell. In first case, what will happen? The cell will become turgid. Okay, students. I hope you understood this concept also. And what will happen, student? In isotonic solution. Isotonic solution means what? Inside and outside, if the water concentration is same. Means inside the cell also the same water concentration. Means here I would like to take this first example only. Once the cell becomes turgid, means inside the chana or what? Same water, and outside also the same water. Inside also same water concentration, outside also the same water concentration. So now what will happen? The movement of the water will be from outside to inside and from inside to outside. Anyhow, the movement can take place, or the movement may stop also. Okay, it will not, means already it has swollen, so it will not further swell up until it form a ball like structure. It will not happen like that. Okay, so what happened here? The water movement is possible from outside to inside and from inside to outside until further limit. Later on, the cell will be like that only. And that will happen into the isotonic solution. That will happen into the isotonic solution because the water concentration is same into the cell and out of the cell. Okay, so based on these, osmosis process is taking place. Osmosis means what? Simply the movement of water from high concentration to the low concentration across the cell membrane. Endosmosis means what? The movement of the water from outside to inside the cell. That is called as the endosmosis. That process is taking place into the hypertonic solution. In this case, the cell becomes turgid. Okay? And hypertonic solution means what? The concentration of the water is high. The concentration of the water is less. Means the solution is more concentrated. In this case, what will happen? From inside, water will move to the outside. Okay? And that is called as a exosmosis process. And isotonic solution, what will happen? Inside and outside of the cell, the water concentration is same. So there will be net movement will be also there. Or further, there will be no movement also of the water particles. Understood? And the limit of this, it will not happen that it will burst and all. Okay? It will be as it is. Or it will not burst also, as well as it will not swell up like a ball or football. It will be up to the mark. Okay? So this is all about osmosis. Now, we'll go about bulk transportation. Bulk transportation. What is mean by bulk transportation? Bulk transportation. Bulk transportation means what? The movement of the solid, liquid or gaseous, solid and liquid, especially gaseous, no? Solid and liquid particles are taken as a whole. As a whole, these are being taken inside the cell. By rupturing the cell membrane, and that particles are coming inside, they are forming a vacuole, right? And that particle is getting digested by the cell and excreted also by the cell. So, the whole particle, or the solid and the liquid particles, are taken inside the cell, right? Taken inside the cell by rupturing the cell membrane. That is called as the bulk transportation. Bulk is what? Means the food particles are taken. Food particles in the form of solid and liquid are taken as it is into the cell. Okay? So, this bulk transportation is actually divided into two forms. That is, first is pinocytosis, that is coming into the endocytosis. Mainly it is coming into the endocytosis, and endocytosis it is coming pinocytosis, and second is coming phagocytosis. Now what does mean by pinocytosis and phagocytosis? I see a students, what happens if there is a cell of the amoeba, right? Then
or this pinocytosis is also called as a sand drinking. Means liquid material is coming inside the sand. Liquid material is coming inside the cell. But how it is coming? The cell membrane is getting ruptured. That particle, liquid particles are coming inside, forming a vacuole, right? Food vacuole we say simply, but that is called as a, that is a specific name is there, pinozoa. That is called as a pinozoa. That is called what? Pinozoa. Pinozoa and lysosome combine together. Pinozoa and lysosome combine together to form pinolysosome. And after forming this pinolysosome, the cell is utilizing that. Okay? Pinocytosis is called as a cell drinking. Drinking, water is only drinking, na? So liquid, in the liquid form, the substance is coming inside. That is called as a cell drinking. That is, pinosome is forming, right? Food vacuole is forming, food vacuole in the form of liquid. Then lysosomes are present. Then pinosome and lysosome combine together to form a pinolysosome. And that material is getting used by the cell. That material is getting used by the cell. This is what? Endocytosis. Why it is called as endocytosis? Because that food particle in the form of liquid has taken inside the cell for the digestion process, for the nutrition process. So this is called as a pinocytosis. Okay, liquid material. Now what is mean by phagocytosis? Phagocytosis means what? Cell eating. This is cell drinking. This is cell eating. Cell eating means what? Something is eaten which is solid. So here what happens? The particles, that food particles, which is in the form of solid, that coming inside, forming a vacuole, that is called as a phagosome. That is called as a phagosome. Beside it, the lysosome is also there. That is called as a lysosome. The phagosome and lysosome is together called as a phagolysosome. Phagolysosome. So, zone. And what happens? This phagolysosome is getting digested by this. This process is especially taking place into the amoeba. This both are taking place into the amoeba. In our cell also this process is taking place. This process is taking place in our cell also. You are knowing from WBCs, white blood cells, right? Which is called as the army of our cell. Whatever the foreign material, whatever worn out cell, whatever the foreign particle would enter inside, that particle will be eaten by the process of this pinocytosis or phagocytosis. Okay, so in our spleen is also there in our body. So that process of eating that food is taking place in our body also by the process of, by the WBCs. So this process, both the process are taking place into amoeba. Okay, pinocytosis and phagocytosis come under endocytosis. Now what is mean by exocytosis? Endo means what? Inside. Exo means what? Outside. Now in both this process, what will happen, student? As the food has entered inside, this food has utilized by the cell. Now after utilization, some excretory material is going to be formed. That excretory material also, suppose the digestion assimilation process has taken place. Now that excretory product will also form one vacuole. In that vacuole, that excretory product will get formed and that will come across this cell membrane, and by the cell membrane will get ruptured and that excretory material will go out. Whenever this excretory material will go out, that process is called as what? Exocytosis. I hope you understand this process. That is what endocytosis and exocytosis. Endocytosis come under pinocytosis, phagocytosis and exocytosis. And this is coming under the bulk transportation. So I hope, students, this concept is also clear for you. Thank you so much.